Entering the most anticipated season in program history in 2012-2013, the USC Upstate men's basketball team played some of the top teams in the country. They faced off against a pair of eventual number 4 seeds in the NCAA tournament, a Sweet 16 participant, and the eventual NIT champion. The Spartans finished the regular season playing some of the best basketball in the league, as they routed ETSU by 32 points on the road, then opened the Atlantic Sun Tournament with a 14-point victory against Jacksonville. Upstate's A-Sun Championship semifinal contest against Mercer will go down as one of the top games in conference tournament history, as the Spartans battled the Bears in a game that saw the lead change hands 10 times and the score tied on 10 other occasions before Mercer captured the win in front of a standing room only crowd of over 3,500 fans. Torrey Craig continued to make history in the season when he was just one of two players in the league as unanimous first-team all-conference selections. Craig also won the A-Sun scoring title for the second straight year, becoming just the second player in conference history to lead the league in scoring in back-to-back seasons.
First, I'd like to congratulate all the student-athletes that are here tonight. The student-athlete themselves, the coaches, if you get right down to it, we're the ones that know how much work everybody puts into it. So I'd like to say congratulations to all those in all sports here at Upstate. As far as our season went, I think we as a group of players and coaches a little bit disappointed in how things went. We were up and down, played really good at times, not so good at other times. And usually it was just in spurts, small spurts in games, but it was enough to lose some games that we would have liked to have won. We finished out very, very strong. That's something, real strong, played for three high-level games at the end of the year, so hopefully that's something we can build upon. Well, he did play very well at the end of the year, as did all our guys, and I think that they're intertwined. When you have a number of guys performing at a higher level, it loosens things up for Torrey, and I think Torrey and Ty had a lot of pressure on them throughout the year because their scores. So to see that happen at the end of the year, to recognize what Torrey's been able to accomplish over his career is really a special thing and a unique thing. Well, the Mercer game was a high-level game, I think, and it was a high-level game for, a good 39 and a half minutes. It wasn't decided until the last, less than a minute to go. So, and I think it probably took a little something out of Mercer, and Florida Gulf Coast capitalized on that the next day. But it was a lot of fun to coach in, a lot of fun for our guys to play in. There was a couple real big calls late, one play that wasn't called, and then we missed a layup. So it was very, very tenuous throughout the game, and because of the high level play, it was a kind of a tense game. Now, Rob has been with us for 3 years. In his first year, he tore his Achilles, and that's a very, very difficult injury to come back from. And he worked real hard and persevered over time, and certainly now we're hoping for the ultimate goal for him is to finish up with a degree.